Hi friends, and welcome back. It's Mrs. Vincent. I left you with a little bit of a cliffhanger the last time I recorded this video, and it was with a little bit of bad news. Remember, they have taken this pet rabbit home with them for the long holiday weekend, and Bradley is so worried that he has set up shop next to Douglas's cage for the long night, hoping that something isn't wrong, but right now it certainly seems that way. So I did tell you that the title of chapter 4 is called Bad News, and I encouraged you to make a prediction. Sometimes our predictions are spot on, and then other times they're not quite so right. And that's okay, because you're still thinking about what you're reading and what you're hearing. And it is perfectly fine for predictions to change if you get new clues throughout the story. So your prediction right now might be reasonable, it might be correct, but it might not be, and that's okay. So for right now, we'll jump right back in. Chapter 4, Bad News. As soon as Bradley woke up Saturday morning, he peered into the cage. Peer means to look closely. So right away, as soon as he gets up, he's looking in the cage. Douglas was sitting in a corner. He wasn't moving. "Douglas," Bradley whispered, "are you all right?" Bradley reached into the cage and put his hand on Douglas's back. The rabbit felt warm, and Bradley could tell that he was breathing. But that was all he was doing. Bradley started to get dressed. "What's going on?" Brian asked from his bed. "Doc Henry told Mom to bring Douglas in if he didn't get better," Bradley reminded him. And he didn't. Brian sat up and blinked. "I'm coming too," he said. The boys got dressed, woke their mother, and made themselves cereal for breakfast. Between spoonfuls, Brian called Nate. "We're taking Douglas to the vet," he said. "You want to come? Get Lucy too." When Nate and Lucy arrived, Mrs. Pinto drove them all to the vet's office on East Green Street. The four kids crowded into the office with the cage. Dr. Henry was waiting. "So here's the mystery bunny," he said. "Let's take a look." Dr. Henry gently lifted Douglas out of the cage. He placed the rabbit on his examination table. Bradley noticed that Douglas was trembling. "Why is he shaking?" he asked. So sometimes the author gives you clues. That word trembling, that's a pretty challenging vocabulary word. So give yourself credit if you knew that it meant shaking. Sometimes my dog does that when she's scared or cold sometimes. Or sometimes she just, you know, hits it in the right spot and she kind of shakes a little bit. So he's trembling. And Dr. Henry says, "Well, he's scared." The vet ran his hands all over Douglas's body. He looked inside his ears, eyes, and mouth. He weighed Douglas on a small scale and took his temperature. He parted Douglas's fur and studied his skin. "Well, I'd say this is a very healthy rabbit," Dr. Henry stated. "His eyes are clear and his teeth are perfect." Bradley showed Dr. Henry the pellets he had in his pocket. "These are a fine brand of rabbit food," the vet said. "Someone took very good care of this fellow." Here is a picture of the examination process. So certain tools that a veterinarian uses, teeny tiny ones to look inside of teeny tiny rabbit ears. And something that a picture can't show is that trembling. So that kind of shaking from the animal. So we can't really see that, but you can see that the rabbit's eyes are closed. We can also see how he is feeling in the background. He's feeling really nervous. Remember, it's his responsibility to take care, but he's in good hands with Dr. Henry. So, and that's what Dr. Henry says too, that the food that was left, remember this is the mystery rabbit, the food that was left, he's been very well taken care of. "So what could be wrong with him?" Bradley asked. "He won't move or anything." "I've seen this before," the vet said. "Dogs, cats, even monkeys sometimes stop eating when they feel lonely. I think your rabbit misses his owner. He feels abandoned, confused. He may be in shock, and that's why he won't eat or drink." The kids looked at Douglas on the table. Dr. Henry put the rabbit back into his cage. "I'm afraid Douglas will become very sick if he doesn't start eating and taking water," he said. "He could die." "But what can we do?" Bradley asked. Dr. Henry stroked the rabbit's soft ears. "If this were my rabbit, I'd return him to the real owner," he said, "and soon." But their lion is the problem. Who is the mystery owner? So we have learned from Dr. Henry that animals can sense loneliness. So he mentioned dogs, cats, monkeys, and now rabbits sometimes start to act differently when they're not in the presence of their normal families, their normal owners. And that is what he predicts is wrong with Douglas, that he is missing his real owner. But when you stop eating and you stop drinking as a person or as an animal, any living thing needs food and water in order to survive. And that's why Dr. Henry is saying soon. And that is where I will leave you for today. Until next time, bye friends.